Very good morning to all of you. Today we will understand two programs related to array.
Now, so our first program is to delete duplicate elements from an array. So first of all, we will discuss our logic. Now, our first point is we have to input the size and elements of an array. So we have to take two variables named size and array. Take two variables. Number one is size and number two is array. Now, our point number is 2 is to find duplicate element in the given array, we have to use two loops. One is outer loop and the other one is inner loop. In outer loop, we have to select each element of an array and check the next element for duplicacy. Now, so what is the loop structure? We have to use the for loop for I equal to 0, I is less than size, and I plus plus to do. Now, we have an inner loop, and in this loop, we have to use the structure like this for j equal to I plus 1, j is less than size, and j plus plus. So now our next fourth point is inside the inner loop we have to check for duplicate element. If duplicate element is found, then we have to delete the array element. Now, and also we have to decrement the size of an array. So the size of an array is given by size minus 1. So students, let us discuss the program structure. So we have to include a file. Here we have defined a macro, maximum size equal to 100. Now in the main function we have declared an array of size 100, a variable named size to decrement the size of an array, and three variables I, J, K. Now, first enter the size of an array. How many elements you want in an array, you have to enter here. Now again, enter the elements in an array one by one. For I equal to 0, I less than size, I plus plus, scanf percentile D, address of ARR of I. Now, this is our main logic. As I have told you that this is the outer loop and this is the inner loop. So outer loop is used to select an element one by one, and inner loop is used to check the duplicacy of an element. So for I equal to 0, I less than size, I plus plus. For j equal to I plus 1, j less than size, j plus plus. Here we have compared the element. If both the elements are equal, then we have to shift elements and decrement the size of an array and the loop. Now after that, we have printed the after elements, after duplicacy element, removing the element, we have to print the array. So this is our first program. Now we are going forward for the next program, and our next program is to merge the elements of an array. So in this, what we have to do, so let we have two arrays, that is array 1 and array 2. In this, we have these elements 1, 3, 5, 7, 9, and in array B, we have three elements 0, 2, 4. So we have to merge these array, and at last, we got this array in the shorted order. So number of elements in the merged array is equal to number of elements in the array 1 and array 2. So what we have to do, we have to compare the elements one by one, 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 7 and 9. So to merge an element, we have two methods. One is to short, we have two shorted array, and we have to compare the elements one by one and put it in the third array. Now the second approach is we have two arrays A and B, and they are not in shorted order. What we have to do, we have to put the element of array 1 and we have to put the element of array B in the array 3rd, and after that we have to short this array. So this method is quite easy in comparison to this method. So let us understand our program. So what we have done here, we have include a file, header file stdio.h, we have include a file conio.h. Here we have taken two arrays of size 50, and the third array in which the elements of A and B will come here. The k equal to 0, I and j are the variable for loops, and n1 and n2 are the size of the arrays A and B. So how many elements you want in an array A, you have to enter here. How many elements you want in an array B, you have to enter here. Enter elements in shorted order in array. So we have to enter the elements in an array in a shorted order. Now again, we have entered element in array B in shorted order. So this is the loop. Now this loop compares the element of two array until the one array is exhausted. For this we have to use this loop. I is less than n1 and n j is less than n2. If a I is less than bj, we have to put a element in the third array. We have to put the array of array A element to the third array, and we have to increment the pointer, because the next element will come in the next location. If this condition becomes false, then we have to use this. Now one of the array is exhausted or completed, but we do not know which one. Therefore we have to check I and j, we have to check I and j accordingly, and we assign the remaining elements in the third array. So this is the logic for that. At last we have to print our output, that is the merged array. So this program is important for you. At last I am providing you the whole program. Thank you very much, students. Stay in tune for next lecture.